Today we're going to take a look at creating a Gantt chart that shows actual and plan in one view. We also get to see percentage completed. You can see it as the green bars inside the actual bar. Now I have two videos on the Gantt chart. The first one is called the quick Gantt chart. It just shows one view, right? It's very easy to make, but you just have one view. You can see when each task is starting and how long the task takes. Then came the second video that was called the fully featured Gantt chart. This shows you actual, but it also shows you the percentage completed. But what you also get is the ability to switch to plan. So you can see two views in one chart. Then I got the request of creating a Gantt chart that is basically based on this, but it shows plan and actual as one view. So here I have the tasks I need to complete for my project. This part is the planning of my project. So I've put a start date for each task and the number of working days I think the task is going to take me. The end date is automatically calculated using the Workday function. And if you're curious to find out more about how this works, make sure you check out the first two videos on the Gantt chart where I go in more detail on the setup of this part. Here is the actual data. So once we come to actually do the task, we're going to update the start date, we're going to update the number of working days, end date is going to be automatically calculated, and we're also going to manually update the percentage completed for that task. So for example, the second task here is 80% complete. Once we finalize the task, we're going to update this to 100%. Now we want to create a Gantt chart that's going to show all of this in one view. And in addition to that, we want to get a line that shows today's date. On this side right here, I've created a data preparation table. This is something I like to do when I make non-standard charts. This way, I can manipulate the data for the chart, because it's not always the case that I can take the data as shown in here in the chart. And especially for our Gantt chart, we do need to make some adjustments. For the task here, I've just added it so I have everything in one place. That's just a direct reference to this cell. Let's just drag this down. For the start actual date, that's again a direct reference to my start date under actual. So that's this one. Let's push this down and fill with that formatting. Number of days, that's the difference between my end date and the start date. And let's also send this down. The number of days completed. For this, if I have 100%, I want to show the full number of days here. So that's just a basic calculation. I'm going to take the number of days and multiply it with this percentage and send this down. Start plan date, that's simple. That's the start date for my plan. Let's just highlight F2, Control Enter. The number of days, we have a similar formula to before. It's the end date minus start date for plan. And let's send this down. Now let's start creating the chart. But here's the thing, whenever you come to creating non-standard charts, it's not always easy to get them look like the way you want them to look. So if I highlight this and I go to insert, and I start off by inserting a stacked bar chart, it looks like this because Excel tries to take a good guess at what you want where. So it's plotting the dates on the vertical axis, but I actually want the dates in my chart. You have different options here. You can start off with an empty chart and bring each series one by one, or you can fool Excel a little bit by telling it that this is not a date. Instead, these are just numbers. I'm going to change the formatting of this to the general format. And now I'm going to do the same thing I did before, go to insert and insert a stacked bar chart. Now I plotted the dates inside the chart. So now I'm going to go back and turn these back to dates. I have a stacked bar chart. First stack is this date. The second stack is the number of days. This is actually the important piece of the puzzle here. This part is something I'm going to hide from view. So I'm going to make this invisible. But first, let's make some other adjustment to this. Let's switch the order of this so that sign off is on the bottom of the chart. So let's bring up the properties. Press Ctrl 1 or double click to bring up the chart options here. To turn this around, put a tick mark for categories in reverse order. So I'm right on the axis options here. Select categories in reverse order. Now the second thing I'm going to do is to hide these. So let's go to the options here under fill options and select no fill. Now in addition to no fill, I want my data set to start from here. There's no reason to have this huge empty space here. So let's go and change our minimum value under the axis options and let's fix that to a later date. So here we don't see them as dates, we see the dates as numbers. I'm just going to change this to 43450 instead of 350. So that's going to bring this a bit closer. So you can adjust this depending on your data set. So let's make this wider as well. Now I don't need the legend right here. Let's delete. I don't need the vertical grid lines. Let's delete. And let's update the color of the bars here to a gray color. Okay, so that's the actual number of days I need for each task. Let's add in the number of days completed. Now the method I used in the previous video is to use error bars for this. That's the same method I'm going to use right now. I explained that a bit more in the previous video. So if you're interested to learn a bit more on how they work, make sure you check out the previous Gantt chart video. To activate the error lines, highlight the invisible series first, go to the plus and put a tick mark for error bars here. Now let's go to more options and check out which one we're at. It's the horizontal error bars and these are the ones we need. We need the plus side only. Our marker is right in the middle, but we only want to show the plus error bars. We don't want a cap and we're going to change the value to our number of days. So for the positive error value, that's going to be the days completed. Click on OK. Now let's go and make them more visible. Change the line color to a green color and make it a lot thicker. So I'll just increase this to 6. That looks good. Okay, so that's the percentage completed. Now let's just make sure that this works. So this one is 20%. If I change it to 50%, 50% completed, 80% completed. Okay, so now comes the part where we're going to add the plan data to this chart. In order not to make it so confusing, I'm going to add a thinner line below the actual bars to reflect the plan. Now here comes the tricky part. I need to plot a scatter plot here. I'm not going to use a stacked bar chart. A scatter plot though needs values, numbers on the x and the y axis. Now on the x axis I have my dates, but I need numbers on the y axis. And the default for Excel is that you get the 0 right here, you get 1 right here, 2, 3, 4, and so on. I want to make sure that my scatter plot for plan is just below this bar here. So if this bar is plotted at around 1 and I want to plot a point below this bar, I'm somewhere down here close to the 0 if we just look at the sign off task. So if I assume that this point would be something like 0.2, and of course you can adjust it later if it doesn't work properly, but let's just try 0.2 and then we're going to add a 1 to this and just pull this all the way up. Okay, so we have our plan scatter plot at 1 unit intervals. The date should be the start plan date. Next challenge is to bring this data into the chart as a scatter plot. But first, Excel doesn't know that I want a scatter plot, so I just have to bring the data in. I'm going to go to select data. Let's add series name is start plan date. And series values, well, to make my life easier, I'm just going to add the Y values to these. And the Y values are the values I just created right now. Add these in and click on OK and OK. Excel thinks that I want to add another stack on top of this. I don't, right? I want to change this to a scatter plot. So right mouse click, go to change series chart type, stay in the combo view and change the plan date to a scatter plot. Automatically, it's going to activate the secondary axis and gives me automatic 0 as minimum and 9 as maximum. Where are our dots gone? Well, let's go and add in the x-axis, because we only gave it the y-axis. It doesn't know where to plot the x-axis. So let's go back to select data and go and edit our series, add in our plan dates, and click on OK. Now notice that I get the dot right underneath that bar. I don't want to see the dot itself. I actually want to see the number of days that I've planned. The dot is the beginning of my line. So again here, I'm going to use the arrow bar trick and I'm going to activate the arrow bars for the plan. The bar that I don't need are the vertical ones, just delete them. I need the horizontal arrow bars, so activate them. Let's get rid of this box here. Now let's update how we want these lines to look. Our dot is here. We just want to show the plus side of it. We don't want a cap, and we want it to show a custom, and that custom is the number of days we've planned. Click on OK, and that's the correct length of the plan. Let's just update the formatting of this. I'm going to make it a lighter blue, and let's change the thickness to 3 and enter. Now, the one thing I don't need are the original markers, so let's just hide them, activate them, go to marker options, and select none. This way, I can see the plan, and I can see actuals, and I can see percentage completed in one view. So just quickly by looking at this, I know that I completed the first task much faster than I planned. And it looks like I'm going to complete the second task faster than planned as well. Now let's do our last task, and that is to add a line representing today's date. So let's just remove this as well here. The idea is that I'm going to type today's date in. You can use the today formula, but let me just type the date in this case manually in. So let's say it's the 4th of April, 2019. I want a line right where the 4th of April is. This way I can quickly tell where I am on this chart and if I'm on track or not. So in this case, what I'm going to do is to also add a scatter plot. Let's just repeat this date for all these fields here, and let's just add this information in. So right mouse click, select data, add, series name, let's go with today here, the X value. So always look at your chart to see what is plotted on the X side. These are my dates, and that's going to be these dates right here. The series Y values, I'm going to use the Y values I created here for budget, and go with OK and OK. So I must have gotten something added here. I can't see it. And whenever you run into something like this, your points are invisible because maybe they're white or they have no fill color. Go here under the dropdown and find your series from here. So my series that I just added is series today. The dots are here, they're just not visible. And in this case, I don't necessarily want to make them visible, but what I want to do is to make a line connecting these dots. So I'm going to activate that solid line. Let's just change the color to this blue here. Update the transparency. I'll go with 40%. Thickness is fine. Let's add an arrow type to the top. And that's that. That's the line reflecting today's date. Let's just add a title to this. Now let's test a few things here. Let's change the date to the 4th of March. That shifts automatically. What I'm going to do actually is to add a label to this, but only to the top part. So I'm going to pick the top data point, which means click twice on that data point. Right mouse click, add data label. Then click and click again to only select this data point. Press Ctrl 1 to bring up the options, or double click to bring up the options, and add the series name to it. I'm going to take away the Y value and this leader line options. For label position, I'm going to add that above. I'll just tweak this a little bit. I'm going to add a solid border to this, the same color, a solid fill that is white, 50% transparent. So just in case the today date is up here, that I can still see what's behind it. You can also tweak this further. If you don't want a straight line like this, you can update the dash type here. You can do the same for the data label here. Just make sure that whenever you're formatting it, that you double click on that data label so you only select that label and you don't activate all the data labels for this series. Okay, so let's update this again just to make sure everything works out. This moves up here. Add a percentage completed for this one. Change actuals. Let's say instead of 13 days here, we realize that we actually need 15 days and these all update automatically. So that's our fully featured Gantt chart that shows the actual and plan in one view. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to become more advanced in Excel, consider subscribing.